Let's start with the design. It looks stunning from behind, with a majestically rising rear spoiler and delightfully detailed lights. It's a little plainer at the shark-nosed, and slightly Lightning McQueen-esque, front, but proportionally it's absolutely perfect. With its nose to the floor, Aston describes this car as a hunter. That's opposed to the more graceful DB11, which sits with its nose more skyward. It's certainly mean and muscular, with clever aerodynamics, some you can see and some you can't. Under the skin, the Vantage shares much with the DB11. That includes the fabulous, Mercedes-sourced 4.0-liter twin-turbo V8, tweaked and tuned in-house for what Aston feels are the right power characteristics. The noise is a little less shouty than in an AMG, too. Under your right foot you'll find 503 bhp and 685 Nm of torque. For now, the Vantage is only available with a ZF8 speed automatic. A manual is due later, we're told. The final drive ratio of the torque converter auto is slightly shorter in the Vantage than the DB11. Along with double wishbone suspension at the front, the Vantage uses a solid subframe and multi-link setup at the rear, offering more of a connection to the road. There's also an electronic differential, which, according to Aston's chief engineer Matt Becker, enabled him to tune the characteristics of the car to make it feel longer or shorter. Or in this case more playful and rewarding. Swing open the driver's door and you're invited to slip into the Losec Sports seat and become cocooned in a cabin that answers many of the quality criticisms we had of early DB11s. While a 911's interior is like a super cool high-tech kitchen, the Vantage is like stepping into the library, more cosy-sitting, comfortable but no less exciting or intriguing. There are no token back seats in the Aston, but there is room for a couple of sets of golf clubs underneath the tailgate. Other storage inside is limited, too, there's not even a glove box. The Mercedes-sourced switchgear is nicely integrated this time around, although the tech is a step behind the German brand's latest offerings. The driving position is spot on, though, with plenty of adjustment to make you feel totally connected to the controls. Prodding the wing starter button in the middle of the center stack fires up the V8 with its burbling baritone. It's a great sound, especially with the optional quad pipe sports exhaust fitted. Pulling away in sport mode, the most comfort-orientated of the three options, and letting the gearbox shift cogs itself reveals a slick change that's matched to a surprisingly compliant ride. This is a sports car, however, it's not meant to cause it, so the Vantage will constantly inform you of the quality of the road surface, while taking the edge off the worst bumps. Up at cruising speeds, the exhaust note is still present, reminding you of what will happen if you flex your right ankle. There's also a bit of road noise. But if you want peace and quiet, buy a DB11, the Vantage is its brasher, more boisterous brother. Cycle through Sport Plus and track modes, and the engine, gearbox, steering and damping will increasingly jump to attention, changing the car's character to make it feel sharper, faster and louder. Whichever you choose, this is a seriously capable car. And fun, too. On the road, it provides confidence-inspiring handling with instant responses. The steering isn't 911 sharp, but that's no bad thing. It reacts how you expect, with a directness and weighting that makes you feel at home behind the wheel. The bespoke Pirelli P0 rubber provides a huge amount of grip, too, helping you to explore the car's extraordinary ability to change direction swiftly and flow from bend to bend. The standard steel brakes do a great job of scrubbing speed when you need to, while an optional carbon ceramic setup is available, and advisable if you plan to take your Vantage on track. We tried the car on Portugal's twisty Portimão circuit, and the Vantage excelled. In track mode with the traction control relaxed and the EDIF doing its finest, you can build up to a speed that you would previously have thought beyond your limits. Switch things off and the Vantage's playful character comes to the fore, letting you drift the car gently with enough lock in the steering to bring you back from frankly stupid angles.